Eviction is the name of the game. The housemates.
I don't know, I just feel like if you always put like 10 guys and 10 girls in the same place, like you're always going to have relationship situations. No, I wish I could see his heart, but like four of them, they do the same thing most people that are here together do.
Have you ever noticed anything with Tolanibaj and Neil? Dorothy, how you doing?
I'm fine.
You're good.
Are you really happy for them though?
Of course. Why should I be?
An eviction from the Big Brother house, and at least one of you will exit the lockdown house tonight. Good luck to all of you. The next housemate to be evicted. Tolanibaj.
To the Big Brother house. 10.
And maybe they just don't think, you know, let's just remove Tolanibaj. I know that I am going to be missed for the Saturday parties for a fact. I feel like with Prince, he's a little bit hard to understand. I think he requires a lot of patience that I don't have because I'm not.
I know. What about, what is the conversation he had with Erica? Let's start with that.
He's not here, I'm asking you.
No comments.
You were quite close to Nengi. You are very good friends with her, aren't you?
I am, yes. You think that, okay, they're a couple. Then at times, she randomly says something that you like, that people that are a couple do. But the things that she says would contradict the things that they do.
Wathoni!
Wathoni!
You have been evicted. Please leave the lockdown house. Few places. Looks like it was Kidwire, the next there was Prince, there was a bit of Eric on the side, and then Brighto happened. Were you just...
I didn't run out. The Brighto one, I didn't even see it coming, but I'm happy he did. If at all, I actually preferred Prince to Kid.
What are your thoughts on Neo and V?
For Neo, I thought he'd have asked V to be his girlfriend by now.
Couple, but you kind of encouraged Tolanibaj to get in the mix, didn't you?
Okay, no problem. I'm going to stay out of this because V is not my friend. I'm not. Tolani is my friend. I'm not going to say anything to V.
So you didn't mind if it was broken up?
I don't really care.
Of course. Let's talk about Kidwire and Erica. How do you feel about them?
As long as both of them are cool with each other and they're happy with whatever it is they're doing together, then they're fine.
Think there's a distraction from anywhere?
I don't really pay attention to them that much.
That she's tried to kiss you a number of times. So that means you might...
It was... something that happened when she was intoxicated.
It happened just once?
A couple of times.
Okay, this one.
Please, can you tell me when I'm trying to kiss you?
I will not talk about it now.
Ah. Wait. So the next housemate I call will have 10 seconds to leave the lockdown house. Brighto!
When coming to this house, I had no relationship in mind.
Top heads in that house. Was it intentional or is that you normally?
Let's just think about it.
There is a lot to unpack in today's episode. And guys, you want to stay to the very end to be able to get every juicy tea that I'll be spilling today. Hey guys, welcome back to yet another exciting video from Deb Deb. Today's video is the review of the 6th live eviction of the Big Brother Lockdown Edition house. Guys, I'm kind of losing track. I think, yeah, this is the 5th live eviction show, and I'm bringing to you all the OTs as a lot was said. It's a lot to be unpacked. Guys, if this is your first time of coming across my channel, please do well by clicking the subscribe button. Yeah, I make exciting videos that I'm sure you will love about air, food, and things I love. So, without further ado, guys, let's get started with today's video. So today Life Eviction started with, you know, of course, Ebuka rocking a very amazing, you know, outfit, but that's not the point. Let me get into the point. So Ebuka, you know, went directly into the house and he starts to say, Ozo, congratulations once again for winning, you know, another HOH. This is the second win. Guys, if you've not seen how Elsa was the HOH, I already have a video about that, go check it out. And you know, after I finished greeting Ozo, you know, what's up, he then said, Ozo, I want to ask for your opinion about Prince and Tolanibaj relationship. I say, okay, this is another new dimension, but okay. Ozo goes saying, yes, it feels like each other and whatnot, and he just you know, rambled. Then Ebuka went on and said, what do you think about Tolani and Neo? Ozo was shocked. So was I. I was like, wait, what? Tolani and Neo, where did that happen? What? So everybody was shocked. Everybody was looking and but she was like, that he was like, he did not know. Then Ebuka was like, yeah, because Tolani said she liked Neo. I said, Ebuka has broken the table. But that's not even the beginning. That's just the beginning. Let's go. Then everybody was just looking all confused and whatnot. Then Ebuka moved on to Dorothy and asked Dorothy that what was her opinion concerning Brighto and Wathoni situationship or relationship. And Brighto was like, she's happy for them and whatnot. Then Ebuka was like, okay. It was just, she's happy for them and whatnot and all. Then Ebuka then announced that, today's, you know, the housemates that are up for nomination today are, and it goes by starting Tolanibaj, Trickytee, Kidwire. I said, what? And then Ebuka called all the housemates' name. I said, you messing with me. Apparently Big Brother changed today's rule of eviction, so all the housemates, you know, were up, and it was not then left to housemates voting with people the four list vote, but instead they were going to just call out the three people. Actually, let me just tell you, three people were evicted. Three people with the least votes, yeah. He started off and called and said, Tolani was evicted. Everybody shocked, but I'm like, okay, baby girl, just come out. When Tolanibaj got to the stage, he asked her, how was she was feeling. She said yes. She was really composed in the interview on the stage, first of its kind. Brilliant for her. Then she went on, Ebuka asked about Prince, and she was like, Prince requires a lot of patience, and she's not someone that has such kind of patience and whatnot, but she does really like him. I said, okay, let's see if they can work it out after the house, but I wish them all the best. Then Ebuka went on to ask her about the conversation she had with Erica about Neo. Then Tolani was like, you should ask Neo that conversation about that. Ebuka was like, no, I want to ask you. Then Tolani was like, okay, no comments. I said, sister, really? You're not going to spill the tea? Okay, we should ask Neo. No problem. Anyways, Ebuka then, you know, asked her what she wanted to do and whatnot. Ebuka went back into the house and, you know, started to ask more questions. I said, yes, we are not done for today. Ebuka went on to ask Trickytee about his opinion about Ozo and Nengi, as Trickytee is close to Nengi. Trickytee said, yeah, he's lost about the whole situation, because one minute they are behaving like couples, the next minute Nengi is saying something else that, you know, he feels that Nengi is holding back her feelings, and that was just it. Ebuka then went on to ask if there's anybody that might be a distraction to that relationship working, and Trickytee was like, well, he would have said Neo as a last thing or thereabout. Everybody was shocked that, what? All the girls with Neo, really? then Ebuka was like, what about Kidwire and all? And Trickytee was like, no, Kidwire is just being Kidwire. Like, he's just been himself. Like, there's nothing to Kidwire and Nengi. I say, Trickytee, you are not seeing it the way we are seeing it, but it's okay. We're gonna leave that for you. Then Ebuka came to announce the next evicted housemate, which was Wathoni. So yes, baby girl, you have been saying you wanted to go. Come and be going. Wathoni was evicted, and on the stage she was asked concerning Brighto, and she said, she never saw it coming, but you know, it is what it is and whatnot. As to if she was going to push it after the house, she said she doesn't know where the head of Brighto is, and I kind of get it. Nobody knows where Brighto head is, but it is what it is. Ebuka then went back into the house to then ask Erica about her thoughts concerning Neo and V situationship or relationship. And Erica was like, well, you know, she felt, you know, Neil should have asked her to be his girlfriend by now because they seem to be the serious couple, but she doesn't really care. And then Ebuka brought up the fact of the conversation she had with Tolanibaj, you know, that she was telling Tolanibaj to go for Neil. And she was like, yeah, with what the conversation she had with Tolanibaj, that she, you know, if Tolanibaj wanted Neil, she was going to share Tolanibaj, and it had got nothing to do with V, as V is not her friend. I say, okay, you all are savage. Okay, V did that one last week. Erica is returning back the favor. We see it, sis. We see it. But it's okay. Ebuka then went on to ask Lekan about his opinion concerning Kidwire and Erica. And Lekan was rambling. He was saying, well, I don't think about them. I say, see this one. For weeks, we watched you complain about these two. But it's okay. Go on. As if we have not been watching. Then Ebuka, not stopping there, goes on to say, but you've been saying Erica wants to kiss you to other housemates and all. And Chidi was kind of shocked that Ebuka said it. But I said, yes, we watch it. We be hearing all your conversation. You all, you're not going to deny it. And they were like, oh, yeah, Erica said it once when she was intoxicated. And Erica was like, oh, she can't remember. And yeah, and Lincoln was like, yeah, because you were drunk, so you were intoxicated. So that's why you couldn't remember. And Ebuka was like, but you said, you know, it happened more than once. And Lincoln was like, yeah, it happened more than once. And oh, but you could clearly see Erica is disagreeing. That, wait, what? When did I say that? I'm like, Erica, the first time it happened, yes, we did see it, but we don't know about if it happened the second time. It's just, you know, Lakers account, but that's for them to, you know, talk about and, you know, deal with it. I was expecting that more drama was going to go on anyways after the show, but guys, nothing, even till now that I'm doing it, nothing, you know. Anyways, Erica has two strikes, so I'm sure she doesn't want to, you know, stress it all out and whatnot. Then Ebuka then says, oh, you guys, wait. It was about ending the show. They were like, oh, wait. I'm hearing something. Then he says, oh, the next housemate to be evicted. I say, shut, come in. It's a triple eviction. Wait, if he hasn't seen it coming, he has made his seats coming also. I love this. Play on all of us, you know, emotional and intelligence. Play it on us. Then the next housemate that was evicted was Brighto, and he shocked all of them. He shocked them because they kind of screamed. But I say, he screams. Hello, Mau. Okay, Lord Belish, now you can come and go. It's so sad to see Lord Belish go. That's Brighto, because I like the, you know, the dynamics of the game he was bringing. This was first of a kind in Big Brother Nigeria that someone would actually, you know, come to actually play the game and be manipulative as he was. And I was loving, you know, that aspect of him, because it was the first of a kind I was seeing in Big Brother Nigeria. Like, I see all this kind of character being done in Big Brother UK and Big Brother America and Australia, but this was the first in Nigeria, and I loved it. And I love the fact that actually Nigerians were welcoming and receptive of that. I pray by next year more people actually going with such strategy. So yeah, Brighto was evicted, and on the stage Ebuka had asked him, oh, what next for him? And you know, he was like, oh, going to career, taking professional courses. I've had professional courses from this guy so much, but all the best to him and in his marine field, all the best to him. So yeah guys, that was it. Then Ebuka announced another thing. That's why I say stay to the very end. Then Ebuka announced that by tomorrow, they are going to start nomination process. Yes, the housemates are going to be nominating themselves. I say, whoa, Big Brother have made the money you want to make. Oh, yeah, let them come and start, you know, vote. So I am nominating themselves. I love this. I love all the old Swiss, you know, the housemates. Never sees it coming. We also don't see it coming and whatnot. Big Brother is making their money. I have no problem with that because it's a money, it's a business. You know, you have to make your profit. But I'm yet to see the twist it's going to bring to the game by tomorrow. So by tomorrow, I think 5 p.m. or so. But guys, hi, I'm going to be your plug. I'm going to bring to you the tease of how the nomination, you know, is going. But that's it, guys. That's it from me today. That's it on this episode. Guys, you have been seeing TAD, you know, showing, yes, yeah, something is coming. TAD, that's the word. Watch out for that. Thank you guys for watching. Please, if you got to this extent, please remember to subscribe to my channel, like this video, and share the video with loved ones. Thank you for watching. Until my next video, stay blessed.